डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीएससी पार्ट टू एंड रेस्पेक्टेड लिसनर, ए वेरी वेरी गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टुडेज लेक्चर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ बीएससी पार्ट टू, आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर टुडे ए वेरी वेरी स्पेशल लेक्चर, द रिलेशन बिटवीन द लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन विद दैट इज ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक इट्स डेरिवेटिव, आई मीन टू से डेरिवेशन ऑफ लॉ ऑफ मास एक्शन फ्रॉम दैट इज ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिकली। द टॉपिक आई मेंशन ऑन द ब्लैक बोर्ड हियर, इट हैज बीन selected from that is of BSc part 2 paper 3 physical chemistry, selected from that is of unit 3, title as that is of chemical equilibrium. Dear students, its excess part we have derived in the classroom and rest part I will deliver today. Before proceeding today's lecture, once again I repeat, I bring to draw your kind immediate notice and focus on our previous lecture to define the law of mass action stated by that is a Goodwar and Waage's law. In any that is a reversible reaction, the rate of forward or that is a rate of backward reaction is directly proportional to the active mass and its multiplication either of the reactant and that is of the product participating that is a chemical reactions. In our previous lecture, once again I repeat it, that is Kp is defined in terms of when concentration of gases are expressed in terms of that is of partial pressure, and it will be similar by that is of Kp. Suppose reactant and product are present in the form of liquid and solid phase in such a position, one can express that is of equilibrium constant and one can calculate in terms of that is of its concentration in terms of that is of active mass. I mean to say Kc is calculated, is defined when reactant and product are present in terms of liquid and that is of solid state, while Kp is defined in such a conditions when reactant and product are present in the form of that is of gaseous state also. Dear students, in order to explain and in order to establish the thermodynamically derivation of law of mass action, Goodwar and Waage's, in our previous lecture we have also mentioned that is of a reversible reaction in which N1 mole of A reacts with that is of N2 mole of B to produce that is of M1 mole of C and that is of M2 mole of D. Dear students, in other word, we can say yesterday we have also described in the classroom that using thermodynamic second unit second of BSc part 2, how will you derive that is of unit 3, title as that is of chemical equilibrium. I meant to say that is of content that is of a law of mass action. Law of mass action say that is of law of mass action which is fundamental postulates to define Kp and Kc. In order to define in our previous lecture the reversible reaction I mentioned on the blackboard here, and on the behalf of various thermodynamic quantities, on the behalf of various thermodynamic quantities and fundamental free energy such as Gibbs free energy del G, Helmholtz free energy del A, entropy S, internal energy U, enthalpy H, choose select any thermodynamic quantity. Now let us derive the law of mass action, or let us derive that is of Kp or that is of Kc here. In our previous lecture, once again I repeat here on the behalf of when we are using that is of Gibbs free energy in such a position, the concentration here will be replaced by that is of activity A. I mean to say concentration one can express in various ways, in various method, in terms of active mass, in terms of partial pressure, in terms of activities. Your activities, here that is of activity, it is the kinds of concentration which is depending upon the number of moles and ions, and Ga, Ga, Bb, Ga, Gb, Gc, Gd with the quantitative relation G0A, G0B, G0C, G0D. And their relation in our previous lecture directly I have mentioned here, we had mentioned in our previous lecture the relation between Gibbs free energy with that is of activity AA, AB, AC and that is of AD. Here, dear students, here on solving here, del G is equals to, and separation the individual values here, del G is equals to M1GC plus M2GT minus N1G0A plus N2G0B, del G is equals to del G0 plus RTLN here. Here in this equation, that is of this equation initially is present in the form of log M into M plus N. So one can write in compact form by the fundamental concept of logarithm. Here log m into n Initially, it was present into the form of log n plus n minus. That is of initially this quantity activity A, activity B, activity of C, activity of D, A and B denote here, and that is of reactant here, and that is of C and D denote here. That is a product here. Now this log will be, that is in the form of subtraction minus this one, and one can write log, suppose we consider here that is this quantity, that is of m, then by the fundamental postulate or concept of logarithm here, log m minus that is of log n here. Now let us focus. I bring to draw your immediate notice on this one quantity here, ac to the power m1, ad to the power m2, a to the power n1, ab to the power. And to dear students, once again I explain here we select here, that is of Gibbs free energy. So we select Gibbs free energy in such a position, you have to choose that is of activity here, that is of here, activity here and activity here, or in other case low mass section we select active mass, and that is a partial pressure here. Activity we choose, we select, and on the behalf of when we are considering here Gibbs free energy. So on the behalf of when we select Gibbs free energy in such a position, in terms of activity here will be considered in terms of concentration here. It is the fundamental active mass. Concentration will be expressed in terms of active mass. It will give the value of Kc. When we are using that is a partial pressure, it will give the value of the Kp. And suppose active mass, one can also explain in terms of activity, it will also give to us the value of, that is of Kc here. Here equilibrium constant, which is defined in terms of when concentration is chosen in terms of, that is of activities here. Here hand del G is equals to del G 0 plus R del L Kc. To dear student, now once again I repeat, we select here, that is of a thermodynamic quantity, that is of Gibbs free energy, and that is of Gibbs free energy, and by assuming the establish its by taking the activities of reactant A, B, C, A, C and A, D. And that is of when we are using here, that is of change in Gibbs free energy. You have to remember here, important point here, three types of the Gibbs free energy it will be used here, that is of G, simple G, which is defined at any temperature, and G naught, or in normal way it can be, it can also be noted that is of del G naught, and del G, that is of change in free energy. And these are the fundamental distinction and derivation. Now we derive here, that is of thermodynamic quantity here, on the behalf of thermodynamic quantity here. Now we will discuss, we will deliver in the classroom very very special, that is of Clapeyron equation tomorrow. Thank you very much.